Welcome friends, Igor is here, and in this video, we will apply column space of a matrix to find spanning trees and networks. Let's get started. Let's consider an oil pipeline construction problem. Suppose we have 5 oil fields. These sites are labeled as 2 through 6, and we have 1 refinery. It is labeled by 1. We would like to construct a network of pipelines which would allow oil to flow from each of the oil fields to the refinery. Let's say these are the pipelines we can build. The arrows indicate the direction of the oil flow. Let's analyze this problem mathematically. For example, we can record the flow at each node of this network. If the flow comes with the plus sign, it means this is the flow into the node. And if the flow comes with the minus sign, it means it flows out of the node. Notice that unlike similar traffic flow problems, there are no equations here for us to solve. But let's look at the expressions which represent the flow at each node more carefully. We can rewrite these expressions in a more rectangular way. And now you should recognize that these expressions correspond to a left-hand side of a certain linear system. What we are missing are the equality signs and the vector of constants on the right-hand side. Similarly, with linear systems, this structure can be described by what we called a coefficient matrix. Let's understand the meaning of this matrix. This matrix has 6 rows, 1 row for each node of the network, and 10 columns. Each column corresponds to 1 branch of the network. Moreover, each column contains zeros. 1 entry is equal to 1 and 1 entry equals to negative 1. For example, let's look at column number 1. It has 1 in position 1. That means this is the flow into the node 1, and it has negative 1 in position 2. It means it's flow out of node 2. At this point, you may wonder, why would we even care to construct this expression and construct this matrix? Let's see. It would be natural for us to try to construct the most optimal pipeline network. We're looking for a smallest network of pipelines which connects each oil field to the refinery. For example, in this big original network, we do not need the branch X7. If we delete this branch from the network, the oil from field 5 can still get to the refinery through oil field 2. Why could we discard this branch? It's because it was part of the loop. There is no need for oil to flow around the loops. So the optimal pipeline network, a smallest pipeline network, has the following properties. It is a connected network and there are no loops. Connected network means that the branches in the network span all nodes of the network. And in the previous video on traffic flows, we determined that loops in the networks correspond to elements of a null space. A network with these properties is called a spanning tree for the original network. The tree means there are no loops in a network, and spanning property means that it is a connected network. The branches span all nodes of the network. So, our goal is to construct a spanning tree for this network. Of course, this is not hard to do for this small network visually, but this might be a pretty daunting task for a larger network. Here's where linear algebra comes to our rescue. We have this 6x10 matrix A where the rows correspond to the nodes of the network and the columns correspond to the branches of the network. To construct a spanning tree, we would like to remove some branches in the network that we do not need to transport the oil from the fields to the refinery. In other words, we want to remove branches that create loops, meaning we would like to remove columns of this matrix which contribute non-trivial elements to the null space of the matrix. But we do want to keep those branches in the network that span the network. In other words, we want to keep the columns of the matrix that span the column space of A, and they are linearly independent. But a linearly independent spanning set for the column space of the matrix A is a basis for the column space. And in this video, we already figured out how to find the basis of the column space of any matrix. All we need to do is to find the reduced row echelon form of this matrix. And we can do this by applying the Gauss-Jordan elimination procedure. This video explains how to do it. In the reduced row echelon form, we notice that there are five pivot columns. There are columns 1, 2, 3, 6, and 8. The non-pivot columns are the ones that would correspond to the free variables in the homogeneous linear system, and they are the ones that contribute elements to the null space of the matrix. There are five non-pivot columns in the reduced row echelon form matrix B, so what we would like to do is to remove the corresponding columns from the matrix A. The remaining columns of the matrix A, the ones that correspond to the pivot columns of the matrix B, do form a basis for the column space of the matrix A. Let's apply this computation to our particular network. This computation tells us that the branches 4, 5, 7, 9, and 10 are the ones that contribute elements of the null space of A. In other words, they create loops in the network, and we do not need these branches. This computation tells us that there are five branches that create loops in the network, and we do not need these branches. If we simply delete them from the network, then notice what we get is still a connected network. Each oil field is connected to the refinery. We have no loops, and therefore this is a spanning tree that we were looking for. Of course, this is not the only spanning tree for this network, but at least this procedure guarantees that we find at least one such spanning tree. If you found this video useful, please give it a like to let YouTube algorithm give others a chance to discover this video. And subscribe to this channel if you want to see more of these videos. As always, I hope to see you later infinitely many times. Have a great day.